So, hello, Nina. My name is Paul Chong, and I started the beginning of the Watson Group in Europe almost 3 years ago. So what can I tell you about that situation? Well, it was very much like a startup when we started the Watson Group. We probably had a little bit more money than the average startup, so we had about $1 billion to get going. And it really came off the back of what we did at with Jeopardy, which is the quiz show in America. Not many people in Europe know that particular game, but it really takes a lot of unstructured data and information, natural language questions, and being able to respond in a natural language way, respond with the answer. Now, humans are very good at that. Computers, not so good, because on the whole, they tend to deal with zeros and ones. So this was a great challenge for us. We started that challenge way back in 2006, and it really came to a head in 2011. And then I had the opportunity to actually start the commercialization of Watson back in 2014. Looking at where things are going in the future, there's much to be said around how AI will act and operate to augment the natural skills of human beings. And I think what you're seeing from the chatbot perspective is very much how can systems naturally interact with people. Because I think today we do a lot of search systems, we go into Google, we work out, and we get vast amount of data by which we have to decide what we want to see and what we want to read. Well, if you think about where bots are going, and I know we're at that early stage and embryonic stage of its development, you're going to see a greater natural interaction. So why do you need to search for something when you can have that human system interface, which is far more natural, to get the information you want and ask the questions you want and get the type of responses you want back? So I think the opportunity is huge and vast. I think it's a big threat for those who do search, but it's also a great opportunity for startups. I think one of the interesting aspects for a startup is when you're talking about natural language, you're often, and chatbots, you're often talking about where you're going to get the data from. And so you have to think very carefully about what you're doing when you're developing your business plan, because much of this is about the data, and the data-driven organizations, it's no different when you're talking about chatbots. Chatbots are critical. The data is critical to chatbots. So you've got to think about the type of industries you're working with. You've got to think about the partnerships you operate with, whether they're company or wide, whether it's data that you find on a more public domain like government information. It's that type of thing that brings it together. A chatbot in its own right is kind of interesting, and you can build on top of platforms like IBM and Microsoft. But actually, where's the data coming from? Because without the data, the information is not as valuable. And so I think that's a really important thing. Think about the industry as a startup. Think about who you're partnering with to enrich your service as a chatbot provider, if you like. But there are multiple opportunities, and I think there's also the opportunity to integrate it within many different areas like social communities, social media. So thinking about the integration layers, it's not just about a chatbot that sits as an app, it's what else it's integrated into, things like Telegram, Facebook, into all this type of messaging services are out there. You've got to find these different touch points that we've never considered before in the past in a chatbot way. And I think that's the kind of changing thinking that we've got to put in place. I think, I don't know about your own interaction, you know, with the way that systems work and the way that you interact with people on a call center. So when you have a problem or you can't find your password, either you spend an incredible amount of time looking through the website to find that information, or you wait on the end of a telephone waiting to speak to someone who may not know the answer to your problem. So I know there's a lot of the conversation about disintermediating, taking people out of roles, but the opportunity to provide a better value, a better service, I think is there for the chatbot to take. So I know a lot of people talk about the fact that these are potentially take roles and jobs. Actually, I think it will enhance the things that we do and the way that we interact rather than detract from what people do today. And typically speaking, most people, and we have over the period of time in different eras, you know, the industrial era, we found better things to do as human beings. We found better things that we wanted to do. You know, personally, I want to spend a little bit more time at home rather than working all the time. But, you know, on a serious note, there really are some aspects of finding new social norms where people will find new things to do, and there's a new economy around it, right? So we'll find we'll be doing different things. But as far as chatbots concerned, yeah, I think the next couple of years are very defining.